The entrance antiphon. Upon a lofty throne, I saw a man seated, whom a host of angels adore, singing in unison, "Behold him, the name of the whose empire is eternal."
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The grace and peace of God our Father, the love of Christ, and fellowship with the Holy Spirit be with each one of you. My brothers and sisters, we gather to celebrate the sacred Eucharist, that our hearts can be open to God's grace. At this time, we pause briefly, place ourselves more consciously in God's presence. Lord Jesus, you took our sins to the cross that we might have forgiveness. Lord, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you rose from the dead for our justification, winning for us a share of God's own life. Christ, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you prepare a place in glory for each of us. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. Almighty and ever-living God, you govern all things, both in heaven and on earth. Mercifully hear the prayers of your people and bestow your peace on our times. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son. He lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the letter to the Hebrews. Brothers and sisters, every high priest is taken from among men and made their representatives before God to offer gifts and sacrifice for sins. He is able to deal patiently with ignorant and erring, for he himself is beset by weakness, and so, for this reason, must make sin offerings for himself as well as for the people. No one takes this honor upon himself, but only when called by God, just as Aaron was. In the same way, it was not Christ who glorified himself in becoming high priest, but rather the one who said to him, "You are my son, this day I have begotten you." Just as he says in another place, "You are a priest forever, according to the order of Melchizedek." In the day when he was in flesh, he offered prayers and supplication with loud cries and tears to the one who was able to save him from death, and he was heard because of his reverence. Son, though he was, he learned obedience from what he suffered, and when he was made perfect, he became the source of eternal salvation for all who obeyed him. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The responsorial psalm, you are a priest forever in the line of Melchizedek.
You are a priest forever in the line of Melchizedek.
The Lord said to my Lord, "Sit at my right hand till I make your enemies your footstools."
You are a priest forever in the line of Melchizedek.
The scepter of your power the Lord will stretch forth from Zion. Rule in the midst of your enemies.
You are a priest forever in the line of Melchizedek.
Yours is princely power in the day of your birth, in holy splendor. Before the day star, like the dew, I have begotten you.
You are a priest forever in the line of Melchizedek.
The Lord was sworn, and he will not repent. You are a priest forever, according to the order of Melchizedek.
You are a priest forever in the line of Melchizedek. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. of God is living and effective, able to discern the reflections and thoughts of the heart. Hallelujah. 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 The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. The disciples of John and of the Pharisees were accustomed to fast. People came to Jesus and objected. Why do the disciples of John and the disciples of the Pharisees fast, but your disciples do not fast? Jesus answered them, "Can the wedding guests fast while the bridegroom is with them? As long as they have the bridegroom with them, they cannot fast. But the days will come when the bridegroom will be taken away from them, and then they will fast on that day. No one sews a piece of unshrunken cloth on an old cloak. If he does it, its fullness pulls away the new from the old, and the tear gets worse. Likewise, no one pours new wine into old wineskins, otherwise the wine will burst the skins, and both the wine and the skins are ruined. Rather, new wine is poured into fresh wineskins." The gospel of the Lord. In our first reading from the letter to the Hebrews, for the first time in the New Testament, Jesus is referred to as a priest. Nowhere in the Gospels is Jesus referred to as a priest, because during his time, they were still offering sacrifice in the temple, and as the author to the Hebrews says, he's a priest in the order of Melchizedek, not in the order of Aaron and all his descendants, and the sacrifice he offered will be completely different. Why does the author of the letter to the Hebrews again and again refer to Christ as the high priest? Because he's absolutely convinced that his suffering, death, and resurrection is the ultimate sacrifice, of which all other sacrifices in the Old Testament tradition led up to and are now canceled because of the one supreme sacrifice. Christ instituted the Eucharist in commemoration of his suffering, death, and resurrection during the Feast of the Passover. And that was a very significant sacrificial liturgy for the Jewish people. You know, they're getting ready to leave Egypt, sacrifice a young lamb, take the blood of the lamb, put it on the lintel, and the avenging angel will pass over the Jewish people, saved by the blood of the lamb. It was on the fast, on the Passover, that Jesus instituted the Eucharist. There's an important dimension to that, because at that time the rabbis clearly taught, when you celebrate the Passover liturgically, sacramentally, you Jewish people, be aware that the Lord passes over again and saves you. The Lord passes over again and revives you. The Lord passes over again and forgives you your sins. The Lord is working powerfully as you celebrate this sacrificial feast again. And so what Jesus did at the Last Supper, we repeat here. This is my body, this is my blood. St. Paul, when he wrote to the Ephesians, says, "Anyone who eats the bread," referring to the Eucharist, "and drinks the blood," drinks the wine without recognizing the body and blood of Christ commits a sin against the risen presence of the risen Lord. So we believe Christ is present. But for us, it's the risen Lord who's present, who's no longer subject to the limitations of space and time. So when we're celebrating Mass here at 6:45 at this Blessed Sacrament Church, and someone else in town at the same time is celebrating Mass, the same Christ is present to them. Space, time, limitations, he's the glorified Christ. We don't understand that. It's part of the mystery of God. But clearly the situation of Jesus after his resurrection. I think we tend to view the presence of Christ when we celebrate Mass as static. He's just there. But that's not simply true. The Christ who is present, because the internal dispositions he had when he suffered, died, and rose from the dead, namely his absolute dedication to the Father, his desire to suffer this for the salvation of the world, the forgiveness of our sins, and winning for us a share of God's life. Those internal dispositions are present in Christ, who is with us during the Eucharistic prayer. He's there as one who was totally dedicated to his Father. He's there as one full of love for God's people whom he redeems. He's one who is most willingly to offer himself as a sacrifice for the salvation of the world. And as he's doing that, he sends out his Spirit, gathering us to himself, so that at the doxology, that through him, with him, and in him, Christ is offering all of us to his Father as his brothers and sisters, his friends, saved by his blood. I know that was kind of complicated, but and that's the meaning of when we say that the Eucharist is once again the sacrifice of Christ is made present to us. Christ does not suffer. He cannot suffer physically like he did on Good Friday because he has the glorified body. But the love, the dedication to the Father, the absolute commitment to our salvation, those internal dispositions are as present in the mind of Christ who will be with us as we consecrate the bread and wine as they were on Good Friday. The Lord be with you. As the Father sent his Son to heal and redeem us, we believe he answers our prayers. For all church leaders, may the example of Jesus inspire in them humble service. We pray to the Lord. For the leaders of nations and of our world, may God's desire for unity be brought to fruition. We pray to the Lord. For those isolated in nursing homes and treatment facilities, may Christ be present to them. We pray to the Lord. For this local faith community, may we be joyful recipients of the life that God offers us through this Eucharist. We pray to the Lord. For all members of your family, may God bless them, protect them. We pray to the Lord. For your personal intentions. We pray to the Lord. And finally, we pray for our deceased loved ones, for the deceased members of your family and friends, for the deceased members of our parish, in a special way for Pat Pitts. Eternal rest grant unto them, O Lord. May their souls and the souls of all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received this bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed be God forever. By the mystery of this water and wine, may we come to share more fully in the divinity of Christ. Himself to share in our humanity. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received this wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink. Lord, wash away my iniquities and cleanse me of all my sins. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that our sacrifice will be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Amen. O Lord, grant to us that we may participate worthily in these sacred mysteries, for whenever the memorial of Christ's sacrifice is celebrated, the work of our redemption is accomplished in our midst. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. His death we celebrate in love. His resurrection we profess with living faith. His coming again in glory, we await with unwavering hope. And so, with all the angels and saints, we too praise you as without end we acclaim, Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread. And giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for the many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate this memorial of Christ's suffering, death, and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be here in your presence and minister to you. Humbly, we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may all be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Lord, remember your church spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Walker, our Bishop, clergy, religious, all of God's people. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection. All who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on all of us, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, with all the saints who pleased you throughout the ages, that we too may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Lord's command, and formed by his teaching, we dare to say, "Our Father, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil." Deliver us, Lord, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may always be free from sin, safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant to her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever." And may the peace of Christ be with each one of you. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, what are you doing? Behold the Lamb. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
The communion antiphon: with you, O Lord, is the fountain of life, and in your light we will see light.
Let us pray. O Lord, pour out upon us the spirit of your love, and in your kindness, make those of us you have nourished by this one heavenly bread, one in mind and heart. We ask this through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Go with Christ's peace. The Lord goes with you.